Emma Kemp Last updated 7:40, May 6, 2018. Roy O'Donovan receives red card for a dangerous high tackle on Melbourne Victory goalkeeper Lawrence Thomas. Melbourne Victory have snuffed out Newcastle's A-League fairytale at the final hurdle, defeating the Jets 1-0 to win a record fourth A-League title. Kosta Barbarouses scored the quickest ever grand final goal in the 9th minute to seal a controversial season finale, underscored by the video assistant referee's failure to pick up offside Victory players in the process. And Saturday night's match at McDonald Jones Stadium ended with a sickening injury time incident, when Roy O'Donovan was dismissed for ramming his studs into the face of Joe Marston medalist Lawrence Thomas, who finished the match with his face covered in bandages. Roy O'Donovan collides with Lawrence Thomas. The Jets striker's high kick collected the Victory goalkeeper flush in the jaw as he came out to collect the ball 2 minutes from full time, and referee Jared Gillett issued a straight red card with a lengthy ban sure to follow. Read more, asterisk recap, a league grand final, Newcastle Jets v Melbourne Victory, asterisk a league marvels at Riley McGree's freakish strike in semi-final Victory, asterisk Melbourne Victory coaches miss a league grand final with 4-game ban. Asterisk marquee funds for big names returns in effort to boost A-League profile. It was a horrible end to the first grand final of any major code to be played in a regional town. Roy O'Donovan kicks Lawrence Thomas in the face. Victory coach Kevin Muscat said, "It was just lucky someone didn't get really badly hurt," although Jets captain Nigel Bugard defended his teammate, "To be honest with you, from where I was, and I was right behind it, the ball's in the air, he's sticking a foot at it," Bugard said. Roy O'Donovan finishes his kick to Lawrence Thomas's face. "It's a grand final, there's 5 minutes to go, and Lawrence Thomas has come out and been brave. To be honest, I would have stuck a foot at it. All those players in the opposition team, if they were 1-0 down, would have thrown themselves at the ball as well." Victory players react towards Roy O'Donovan, center, following his kick on Melbourne goalkeeper Lawrence Thomas. "Yeah, it looked ugly, but I guarantee you Roy had eyes on the ball. O'Donovan could cop a lengthy ban considering his disciplinary record." Referee Jared Gillett shows Newcastle Jets striker Roy O'Donovan, 9, a red card on Saturday night. It's his second sending off this season after he was handed a 2-match ban in March for his assault on Sydney FC defender Jordy Bugis when he struck the Dutchman in the face with his hand. In January 2016 he was hit with an 8-week suspension for a headbutt on Wellington Phoenix's Manny Muscat. Newcastle Jets coach Merrick, the Phoenix coach at the time, described the incident as "going back to the dark ages." For the rest of the game on Saturday, the Jets rode the wave of support from the 29,410 crammed into McDonald Jones Stadium in their bid to become the first Australian side in any sporting code to go from wooden spooners to champions in one season. Roy O'Donovan attention from the trainer after being struck in the face earlier in the final. In the end, it was Merrick's one-time protege turned combatant Kevin Muscat who got the last laugh in a contest that started breathlessly but was shut down by Victory's experienced campaigners. While the Jets dominated all the first half statistics, they couldn't overcome the all-powerful Thomas, whose gargantuan saves inspired his side to exorcise the ghosts of last season's grand final penalty shootout loss to Sydney FC. They went behind early when Leroy George's swooping free kick found the head of James Donachie, who knocked it down for Barbarouses to fire past Glenn Moss via a deflection off Johnny Kotrumi's. Replays showed Donachie and two teammates had been offside, yet the VAR remained silent. "It looked to me like there were three players offside," Merrick said. "I don't want to be a sore loser, but if that goal was offside, I just wonder what the point of the VAR is." Lawrence Thomas ended the game with bandages to his head. The Jets responded swiftly, raining down on Victory's goal and navigating away past every opponent bar the brick wall of Thomas. The visiting custodian took reflex dive to deny Roy O'Donovan's instinctive flick off a coach Rumi's cross. Minutes later Thomas topped it, parrying away Riley McGree's would-be equalizer before recovering in time to divert Jason Hoffman's point-blank follow-up shot away to safety. If not for those world-class efforts, the Jets would at least have leveled the ledger, finishing a one-sided first half with 11 shots to 3. McGree ran the midfield while Socceru Dimitra Trotto's and Venezuelan trickster Ronnie Vargas exposed Stefan Nigro on the left flank. Victory players celebrate with some selfies, but they faded after the break as the Jets' early momentum fell victim to a staunch Victory defense run by Thomas Deng and James Donachie. The visitors utilized their big stage experience to close down the game as James Troisi and Terry Antonis began to properly assert themselves. The latter was momentarily felled during an aerial clash with ex-Victory man Daniel Georgievsky. but it was O'Donovan who really came off worse for wear when he threw himself in the path of Bissart Berisha to stop the ball rolling over the goal line and copped a stray elbow the face. The Irish marksman soon had a swollen lump under his eye but clashed with Thomas soon after, trying to get direction on a header before delivering his horrible kick. AAP